What's up guys, welcome back to yet another video. And finally after a long wait, I have my favorite ROM now available for OnePlus 8 series with the taste of Android 12. So if you guys aren't aware, one of my favorite custom ROM was Paranoid Android and now it's back with the taste of Android 12. So in this video, let's take a quick look on that ROM and we'll also show you the installation guide at the end of this video. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So here you can see this is my OnePlus 8 on which I've installed Paranoid Android based on Android 12. Let me show you the software information first. Here you can see Paranoid Android version is Alpha 1, Android version is Android 12. We get 5th October 2021 security patch. Being an alpha build, I haven't faced any kind of major issues yet. I've been using this build since yesterday. These are the benchmark results. With single core device I've scored 898 and with multi-core device I've scored 3153. With AnTuTu benchmark application, device I've scored 677,461. Pretty good scores on alpha build. And guys, I'll be doing a complete review on this particular ROM which is Paranoid Android based on Android 12. So make sure to let me know what all things you want me to cover. In our review videos, we cover gaming performance. We also talk about the bugs if we find anything, followed by the battery backup and the stability of the ROM. So if you have any particular topic to be covered, let me know in the comment section below. Right now, ROM is available for OnePlus 8 and 8 Pro. Once it's available for OnePlus 8T, I'll update you guys about the same thing. Talking about the launcher, ROM comes with Paranoid Android launcher pre-installed, which also have the support of wallpapers and style section from Pixel Launcher, which gives the ability to wallpaper-based theming engine and also themed icon. And wallpaper-based theming works pretty great on this ROM. On the previous builds of Paranoid Android, we used to see Abstract application, which is a wallpaper application that doesn't come pre-installed on this initial build. Hopefully, that will be added in future builds. Also, we get basic AOSP camera, but if you guys want to try out modded Google camera application, I'll leave the link in the description below and I'll also give you a particular APK of Google camera which can be used on this Paranoid Android ROM. But currently I'm testing few Google camera applications and I'll update you guys in the review video which would be good enough to be used on Paranoid Android. All the basic functionalities works fine, like calling had no issues, VoLTE works, both the Wi-Fi bands are working fine, like 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. I've also tested two SIM cards at once and both the SIM cards had no issues at all. No issues were found with any sensor like accelerometer, light, proximity, magnetometer, compass, and gyroscope. All the sensors does their work pretty well. And trust me guys, this is one of the stable Android 12 custom ROM which I've used on my OnePlus devices. Here you can also take a look, alert slider works fine. Charging is also pretty fast, but I'll come up with the battery backup and screen on time in the review video. So stay tuned for that. Fingerprint unlock is pretty fast on Paranoid Android. Though right now we don't get the option of face unlock. And I'm also not sure whether it will be implemented in upcoming builds or not. And also guys, if you're not aware about Paranoid Android is more focused on the stability part. Though we don't get to see much of customization options on this ROM, but when it comes to stability, performance, battery backup, then as said, this was one of my favorite custom ROM in the past. Adaptive brightness is very well optimized. We also have options like prevent accidental wakeups. And always on display doesn't have any kind of issues. Did not face any kind of issues in things like lift to wake and one-handed mode. I've also tested Bluetooth using my Realme Buds Air 2 and there were no connection issues. As said, there are not much of customizations on this ROM, but pretty much optimized and stable enough to be used as daily driver. So we'll be doing a complete review. Let me know in the comment section below what all things need to be covered in the review video. And now let's talk about the installation process. To install Paranoid Android, make sure your device bootloader is unlocked and you should have proper ADB drivers installed on your PC. Later, just download these two files. One is the ROM file and the second one is platform tools. After that, you just need to boot your device into fast boot mode. And if you guys are not aware about unlocking the bootloader, I'll leave a video guide in the description below. After you have successfully booted your device into fast boot mode, open up command prompt in the platform tools. But before that, make sure you have placed the file of Paranoid Android in the platform tool folder. Open command prompt by typing cmd in the address bar. After that, you need to give command fastboot update and followed by the name of this ROM file. Instead of dragging the file, just copy the same name of the zip file and paste it in the command prompt followed by .zip as it's a zip file and hit enter. Installation might take around 4 to 5 minutes. And after completing the flashing process, you might get to see this error: cannot load Android system. Your data may be corrupted. So from here, what you have to do is you just need to select factory reset and wipe user data. And there you can see the boot animation of Paranoid Android. A device should successfully boot now into system. There we have the initial setup and a device have been successfully booted into Paranoid Android. So guys, this was the quick look on the initial build of Paranoid Android based on Android 12 along with the installation guide. If you still have any kind of questions, you can let me know in the comment section below. This is your friend Ashok signing out. See you guys in the next video.